In this movie, before we talk about the reflect tool, I would like to give you a brief overview of the pen tool. Pen tool is an icon which is right there in the toolbar, and you will see two similar icons which are right there. So this one is a curvature tool which we won't be using much. This is the pen tool which we would be using quite often. Now if I hold on to the small triangle here, I will get these four amazing tools which are related to the pen tool. I will just tear it off and bring it on my artboard, because I will be using them to demonstrate to you how to use the pen tool. And also, there are certain terms which, when we use the pen tool, like, you know, there is line segment, then there is an open path and closed path. And you see these big fat squares that you see, actually they're kind of very tiny when you're drawing a line, but I'm just kind of showing you so that you know that these are nodes. Okay, now let's go over and I'll explain to you how to start with the pen tool. So working with pen tool is just like, you know, you're connecting dots. So here, when I start from here, like one, I click once, click twice, again, and there you go. So this is how you are working with the pen tool. Now let's say if I want to disconnect the line and I want to start a new line, so what I do is I click enter. At the moment I click enter, it's sort of, my line gets disconnected and I can start with a new line from here like this and make another polygon if I wish to. Now there's certain indicators that pen tool tells you when you're starting with a fresh line or you're connecting or continuing with the new line. Like suppose I want to start with a fresh new line, and what I'm going to do is here, I'll move it here. So I'm starting with a fresh new line, and you see my blinker has an asterisk sign which shows that I'm starting a fresh line. So I'm just starting, click once and then click again. And if I want to continue with the line, let's suppose I want to continue here, my blinker again says, it's like the sign changes to a slash. So this means I'm continuing with the same path. And let's suppose I want to close this. So again, my blinker changes and it changes into a circle, a closed circle. So this means that I'm closing my path, and this is called the closed path. I can fill it with a color. Like suppose I'll just click here and just add a color like this. So this is how you work with a closed path. Now let me tell you another thing, a very interesting thing. I can close this path as well. I'll just use my eyedropper tool and just select this, and you see this also feels like a closed path, but it's actually not. And you know why? Because it doesn't have a stroke line here. Now this kind of function is quite handy when you're doing your illustrations or when you're making your flats. It's a function that you would be using sometimes, like in hands and all. So this is a very interesting function. Now let's talk about the tools that are there in the pen tool. Now this one is an add anchor point tool, this one is a delete anchor point tool, that is called the minus, and this one is an anchor point tool. Now let's go over here and discuss this. So let's suppose I want to add another anchor point to this. So I'll just add another anchor point, and when I move my line onto the line segment, it says, like, you know, it changes into a plus sign, so it means that I'm adding an anchor point. Now you may be wondering that, you know, why am I telling you this, and what is this actually for? So now this is really useful when you want to change the shape of your object and you have already worked so much on it that you don't want to make it again. You can always go to your direct selection tool and just click on it once. You can't do this with the black arrow key, you always have to do it with the white arrow key. So I am trying to distort the shape with my white arrow key. So the points that I had added, I can, I'm just like kind of changing the shape of it. Now there is another thing, like, you know, if I want to I want to reduce these nodes. These nodes are too many. So if I want to reduce the nodes, I can just click on the delete anchor point tool, and just when I move my cursor around these nodes, it kind of changes to a minus sign. So when I'm working on the pen tool, it is an automatic function. Like I said, I click on the pen tool, I can add the nodes here. If I want to subtract it, I can hover my cursor around it. It will ask me if I want to minus it. So I don't have to click on the plus and minus. It was just to basically to explain to you. But yes, it's always good to know about these tools. And if you're not, if you're very fresh at Illustrator, it is always good to kind of use these tools to understand your work better. Now what we have here is the anchor point tool, which is quite interesting. Now let's say I want to make a curve. So I click on the node and I can make a curve of anything, like, you know, so this is a curve that I'm making, like you see here. So this is how the anchor point tool works. Now when I was trying to do this, like, you know, it's getting twisted itself, so we don't want to twist it. So I go the other way around to untwist it and just click once, like this. So this is how anchor point tool works. And a very handy exercise for you is, like, if you want to really practice this, I would suggest you take a shape, and the shape would be right here. I can take a star shape and I'll click once on my artboard, and let's say I increase the points to 8 and I click OK once. So this is a shape that I have. Just zoom this a bit. And what you can do with your anchor point tool, you can just play around and make a nice interesting flower. So make sure your flower is equal from all ends and it actually looks like a flower. So it's a good exercise when you don't know Illustrator and you're trying to just get a hang of it. So this is a good way of working with the pen tool, where you are understanding how to work with the curves and all. So remember to do this exercise, because we would be using this quite a lot in our flats as well as our illustration. So this is a very nice and handy exercise. Also, if you advance to the pen tool, there is another way of actually doing it, and you can just work your way around it. So it's just click once like this, click again, and then you don't have to unclick it. You don't have to unclick your mouse, and you need to just drag your cursor like this, and then you unclick it, and then you just join like this. So you're sort of making a petal, and if I want to kind of make this petal a little symmetrical, all I have to do is click on the direct selection tool and just click on the node here and just, like, you know, adjust my petal a bit so it actually looks like a petal. So it's quite interesting. This is a very interesting way of working with pen tool. So I hope you will be able to do your best. So let's move on and go to how to work on reflect tool.